Okay, so camera's rolling, so whenever you're ready.
Right, I'm Jonathan, and I'm a music artist. I'm in a group called The Manor.
Hi, my name is Bisola, and I am an aspiring entrepreneur.
Hi, I'm Khari, Oriogun, and I'm a model.
My name is Cherrelle Skeete, I'm an actress, and I'm in a little show called Harry Potter and the Cursed Child at the moment.
Hey, I'm Sharaye, I'm a blogger and a freelance photographer.
I'm Zackary Downs, I do graphic design and other things like that.
I am Khalil, Madovi, I'm an artist, musician and actor.
What is success to you?
Success to me is doing something you enjoy and doing it well. To any, it can be anything.
Success to me is basically doing something you love and, you know, other people benefiting from it as well as you are. Yeah, that's success to me. Being happy doing what you love and getting something rewarding from it.
For me, success, well, by definition, is like is having an aim or a goal and achieving. And success to me, ultimate success is achieving whatever you came here onto earth, or you know, whatever your beliefs are, whatever your purpose is in life, whatever you feel like. Can leave this earth, die, whatever, and feel like you had a successful life, fulfilling a purpose, leaving a legacy. That's what success is to me.
Success to me is achieving something that you've set out to achieve and doing it in a way that makes you happy. So, you know, that can be a day-to-day, because a lot of the times we look at the big massive moments, you know, we look at the things that we see that are kind of portrayed in the media, or you know, what's kind of trending on Twitter. But for you as an artist, I think it's your day-to-day moments that are successes, and being happy with those things. Sometimes just getting out of bed if you're having a bad day, you know what I mean? Making sure that you're looking after yourself because you're having a bad day, that can be a good thing, that can be a success. Which then, you know, means that if you've got to go for an audition and you happen to land the job, or you happen to meet a director, that can be a success, as opposed to there being a specific end product, if that makes sense. It's just being happy, doing something that you love, and being able to live with yourself doing it.
I think doing what you truly want to do and being happy at the same time, because I think there's no point in being where you want to be and being unhappy, or being in a place where you feel like you're alone. So I think it's a balance of being where you want to be and being happy.
Success, I guess it would be being happy in what you do. Also being in a position where you don't have to worry about certain things like money and stuff like that. You know, kind of the bog standard definition of success is my definition.
Success to me is doing what I was put on this planet to do, which is positively influencing those that are watching all the things that I do, bringing light and good energy to bad places through art and creativity and inspiring.
How did you get into the industry?
Got into the industry more out of luck. I always wrote music, always wrote lyrics, and always wrote poetry, and I was a massive music fan. And I graduated in 2010, and I was looking for something to do. I was a bit lost coming out of university. I didn't really want to go into the banking world, which is what my degree led me into. So me and my friend decided to start making music, and it progressed and went from one stage to another.
Yeah, how I got into what I'm doing at the moment, or starting at my company, should I say, was basically I was at a place where I had no job, and in African Caribbean community, or in any communities really, you know, you have connections with people, like your mom can call someone up saying, oh, my child is looking for a job, have you got anything? And they're like, yeah, sure, there's something going on here, if he or she want to come along and see, you know, what I want. So yeah, my mom just called up her friends, who usually does like catering for parties, and they told me to come along and help out at parties. And although at first I was like, good. I had no money, so I was like, sure, why not? So it kind of started up from there.
So when I was 16, I was inboxed on Facebook by some guy, and it seemed I was quite skeptical at first. I took a friend of me to go and meet him, and went to some really cool offices, and it turned out for the best. I mean, within that first month, I was shooting for ASOS, and I was doing Fashion Week, etc. at 16 years old, so it was a big move for me. But yeah, I'm glad, I'm grateful for it.
I actually got into acting through dance. I had a dance company called CRC back in Birmingham. As you can tell, I'm not from old London, I'm from Birmingham. Yeah, I had a dance company, and it started off making some routines with some friends in the bedroom, and then community shows, and then we started to get workshops in the community, and then there was a big niche for spaces for young people, so we took them on board, and the company went from 3 to like 15 in the space of like a month. And then yeah, we automatically became an artistic director, like in the space of a few months really, organising other young people, teaching young people, kind of applying for funding. It happened really quickly. And then I noticed that the type of choreography and movement that I was interested in started to focus more on dance theatre or physical theatre. So there was like this big kind of argument in the company because they just wanted to do sick routines, you know, to some grime tunes, and I wanted to looking into movement that told a story. So then I had a few years out after I'd finished college, and approached a community theatre company because I didn't know anyone that was making money professionally as an actor, and I didn't know how to get into it. And the guy from this company basically sat me down and wrote down all the drama schools that I should go to. Now, I'm from like inner city Birmingham, so like the equivalent of like your Peckham or whatever. So I didn't think people like me went to drama school. Like, I heard of the Judy Dench's and stuff like that. I thought it was people like that, you know, not for a young inner city black girl. So that was first of all having to accept that, and then you know, I managed to get a bursary to then get on a train to pay for my audition for RADA and Central, a musical theatre, because I sing as well. I'm telling you a very long-winded story, but I'm trying to say basically that if it wasn't for dance, I wouldn't be an actor, basically. And then I didn't get in that year because it wasn't the right course for me, and I wasn't prepared. I didn't know how to audition. A year later, I came back correct, was determined to get in, and I only put Central Collaborative and Devised Theatre down on my UCAS form because I couldn't afford anything else, and I thought there's no point in them getting my money when I don't even really want to go there. And that was the only place I wanted to go. So yeah, I got on the course, and then yeah, 3 years later, it was, yeah, so that was, oh my gosh, 5 years ago, 8 years ago I started drama school. So yeah, it's been a bit, yeah.
After university, we kind of all had to decide what we really wanted to do, and I was really unsure. For a while I wanted to go into social media, which I did. I did a bit of social media managing working from home. But studying magazine journalism, they really pushed the blog thing because it really worked hand in hand with what we were trying to do at the time. So I had a blog at university, did a bit of photography here and there, got a camera, and then afterwards I just decided to take it seriously. So I started my blog about 5 months after I finished uni, and then I got a camera for my graduation present, and then I just started taking pictures.
Because I can't really do anything else. I was gonna go to uni, but that's not, I'm dyslexic, so it doesn't really work that way. It's a lot of essay writing, so I'm not really keen on that. So I decided I'll just start doing it on my own, and you know, just work for a couple of friends, do bits and pieces where I can. Really. That's about it. I'm not really in the industry yet, so I can't really say much.
I got into the industry through my dad used to have a small acting agency, and you know, when I was about 12, 13, I was like, hey, I'm gonna try acting. So I knew at that point I sort of wanted to do more TV based stuff. I was really interested in theatre at the time. And so I was like, hey, I better get experience on what auditions are like, because you know, I knew that was a part of the process. And being a musician, this show called 4 o'clock Club came up. It was a new show CBBC were developing at the time. And it was heavily involved with music as well. So I thought, okay, as a musician, this will be something that's comfortable for me to, you know, get my head around what this whole audition process is like. So you know, I went for the audition, and then I was fortunate enough to get a couple of callbacks, and in the end, I got the job. And thankfully, it turned out to be a really successful show, which obviously opened more doors for me and led to more opportunities.
Why is it important to encourage young black people who want to join the industry?
I think it's important. I think there's a lot of young black people that want to be in music. I think music is in black people's genetics. I think it's something that we've all got a strong affiliation with from childhood. And I think it's something that we're naturally good at. So I'd encourage anyone, you know, it is a very good industry to be in. If you're creative and you feel as though you can say things that matter and things that other people aren't saying, I'd definitely would suggest getting involved in music.
It's very important because we don't get enough representation out there. There's this connotation that, you know, young black people are very lazy and they need that extra help. And yeah, so it's very important to have them so they can see themselves doing what you're doing. A representation all around, basically.
It's important to encourage the youth because, I mean, especially, yeah, the black youth, as you say, it's growing. I feel like we were suppressed, we were shut out for a long period of time. In modelling, a lot of black people are used as just sort of art because of our skin colour, because, you know, the dark skin colour is good to use in contrast with like a yellow background or whatever. It was just used as pieces of art. But now I feel like black people are really pushing through and being recognised for their beauty and their uniqueness. So it's important to carry that message on for the next generation so they don't feel the suppression or the you know, the segregation at all. So we've got to keep pushing that for the black people.
Ooh, long sentence there. Why is it important? I think that everyone is creative. I think it's just the educational system and adults that have beaten it out of us to not be creative, or that somehow it's a privilege. I feel like a lot being in, I mean, in any country, you find that within the black community, we're so connected to our creativity. It's kind of something that's within our home, whether that's through music. And it's so funny because I have people that have asked me, do you have anyone in your family that's an actor? And I'm like, not necessarily by trade, but they're all actors in the way that they tell stories. You know, it's very animated and you laugh, and my parents are from the Caribbean, so that's something that's in our veins, you know? And it's for you to choose to tap into that, because it's there for you to tap into. And I think it's a great way for us to get our stories across. You know, every story is valid, and we can't expect other people to tell our stories. So the more people from the communities that aren't getting their stories out there, the better, because it means we're getting a wider view of what's happening in our community, in our world. We're getting a broader picture of what is actually going on. So, you know, you can affect more people through art, which I think is really powerful.
Because the industry needs to represent real life, but at the moment it doesn't. It needs to be diverse, and I think it's really, really helpful when there's people like you in the industry for you to look up to. So, you know, you need black bloggers, black actresses, black actors, black directors, you need them all out there. It's really inspiring to the youth, and it can really have a positive impact on their future and make them realise that they can do whatever they want to do. And even if their image isn't always portrayed in a positive way in the media, they know that there are people out there who have achieved great things and can be what they want to do?
I don't know, I can only half speak for them really. I think it's good to have, I think it's good to give everyone a chance. I feel like mixed race people, black people, Hispanic people, whatever colour you are, I think it's important that you feel that you have the same chances as everybody else. And in some situations you do, and in some situations you don't. So it's always good to strive to be wherever you want to be and not look at an industry and go, oh well, that industry is all that one group of people, I can't be in there. So I think it's always good to push for what you really want to do.
I think it's important to encourage young black people who want to join the industry, because being young and black in this society, a lot of people will try and stop you from doing what you want to do, or they'll make you feel like you're not able to do what you want to do. So I think it's important for those that are already in the industry to encourage, you know, the younger generation to maintain and build upon what we're doing, not only to reach the highest that we're, you know, aspiring to, but to shoot further than that.
Why is it important for you to be an advocate for young black people in the industry and break away from the stereotype of young black individuals?
I feel as though I naturally am. There's a lot of rappers, I don't tend to rap, and my music isn't like a lot of other black artists, as much as I respect them. I feel as though I can't really be pigeonholed as a person. I've never have been. My character has always been very different and unique. And I made sure that my music reflects that. I'm a very genuine artist and I don't really hide much. And I'm very truthful with my lyrics. And I feel as though it's important to be yourself, whereas there is a lot of people, there's a lot of different genres in music. We've never tied ourselves down to one genre. We've always gone with the vibe on the day and how we felt, and we've always been very truthful to ourselves in our music. So it's more important as a person to do, especially with art, to make and create stuff that reflects your personality rather than follow a trend.
I think it's very important to have myself represent, you know, other young black people, but I wouldn't say myself generally. I would just say any black person really. You know, if a young black person can see myself doing all these like events and stuff and thinking, bro, I can't do that, like that's not cool, man. But then they see me doing, they're thinking, yeah, sure, why not? Why not? Because from what I'm doing at the moment, I think I'm seeing more young black people doing it as well. So it's very motivating.
Again, for what I just said, I feel like you gotta push the message that, you know, black people can do and be anything they want to be, and then you've not got to be the stereotype that has been slung on us. Whether it's, you know, you gotta either be a baller or a rapper or a drug dealer to kind of make anything or make any kind of money or be any kind of successful person. So I feel like me, when I first joined modeling, it was considered gay to be a male model, or, you know, you was looked down upon by some of my friends and whatnot. But now it's huge. It's been huge for me. So I feel like I want to push and keep opening doors and to show like the next generation that there's plenty of things out there. You know, you ain't just got to be a rapper or a baller or this or that because you're black. You can be, there's a lot of fields, a lot of avenues. So yeah.
Oh, to be an advocate. I've never really put myself out there as an advocate, but at the same time, I understand my position. First of all, just being in the industry that I'm in is competitive, whether you're black or white. But on the top of the fact that I am from, you know, a working class background, on top of that, I'm female, and on top of that, I'm black. So I know that I'm a minority of a minority, you know, I understand that, and it means that it's put me in a very privileged position, even being in the show that I'm in and having the opportunities that I've had, you know, having gone to drama school and having the experiences that I've experienced through my work. So I feel like any time I speak to any of the young people that are interested in just creating industries full stop or getting into acting, I always try and share my experience, I suppose it's my own testimony, because that's all I can offer really. I'm not the expert, I'm only the expert of my own experience. Everyone else's experience will be different. But I think people from our community, from the black community specifically, that are doing really well and speak about their experiences. I think it's always going to inspire other people, whether it's them making mistakes and learning to not make the same mistakes, or kind of looking at what worked for those people, and maybe they can, whoever's watching, if you're watching, and you can, you know, make it work for you as well. It's just about kind of passing the baton, isn't it?
I think it's just important to be yourself. Like, I've always kind of been, I don't know, seen as not really a stereotypical black girl. And I don't know, like, say for example, when I was in like secondary school, people would be like, oh, you speak so posh. And it's like, no, I just speak how I speak and I'm black. So I don't need to speak, like, there's no typical anything. I am a typical black girl because I'm black, like, and I'm a girl, that's all. So I think it's just important to show that you can be who you are and be how you are without feeling that you need to fit into a box or that you're different because you don't fit into that box. Like, it's important for me to just show, like, just be yourself. And like, especially on my blog in particular, I cover a lot of like relatable topics. So I do stuff on like mental health, anxiety. I did one the other day on like awkward life scenarios, and everyone was like, oh my God, that's me. Because I'm like, I'm so awkward. Like, I might as well do a post saying I'm awkward. And then everyone else is reading it and they're like, I can relate to that. And I love that because I want people to relate to what I'm writing about.
I'm not sure if I'm a stereotype of young black individuals. I don't think I'm a stereotype for a mixed race individual either. I'm just kind of doing my own thing. It's difficult because there's not really a stereotype for me yet. Mixed race people don't really have a stereotype yet. So when they get one, I'll tell you if I'm breaking those rules.
It's important for me to be an advocate for young black people in the industry and break away from the stereotypes of young black people, because it's important for those that are coming next, for the future generations, to see that, you know, whatever their dreams and aspirations are, they can be achieved. It's important for them to see people like them in the places that they want to go to. But also at the same time, it's important to make them understand that, like, the things we do aren't necessarily the things that, you know, the next generation need to do as well. For me, everything, every aspect of my artistry, every facet of my artistry, I try to approach it in a way, in an innovative way. You know, I don't really like to follow or exactly replicate models that have come before me. You know, I'm always trying to look at ways to push the envelope, push the barrier. And I think it's important to do that, because in doing that, you're breaking down doors, and the people that are coming behind you can go even further.
Do you think that the stereotype that is placed upon young black people affects their chances of pursuing particular dreams in specific sections of the industry?
I do think, and I've, now, as I've been in this industry, it's similar to sport, where you feel as though there's a lot of footballers, but there's not a lot of black managers. In the music industry, there's recently been a lot more people getting into music management, A&R-ing, doing work at the label. And there's black, there is Darkus at Ireland who runs the label. I feel as though it may have been a case of we could only be artists 30, 40 years ago, and now there is a lot of important black people in the industry that make the decisions at the top level. So I feel as though it's got better. I don't think it's as much of a hindrance as it has been. And there are a lot of important black people that are leading the way in my music, in the industry, sorry.
Oh yeah, most definitely. I think with like starting a business, really, you know, what comes to mind is money. How am I gonna get the money to start this up? So with black people, if you wanna start up your own business, it's so hard because you don't have enough people believing you. You don't even have your own family and friends pushing you forward saying, do you know what, it's gonna be difficult, but we're gonna support you all the way. Only because when people think of business, it's money. Where are you gonna get the money from? Why don't you just get a job instead? Makes life easier for yourself. Like, there's barely enough jobs for black people, well, good career jobs out there for black people, and you wanna start up your own business rather than put yourself forward. So I think there's a, you know, negative connotation to it again, that for you to start up a business, you need money. When in actual fact, what you need is connections and people that's gonna motivate you to do it.
Yeah, I mean, the whole fashion industry is notorious for being like a white culture at the top anyway. It always has been, from top designers, top photographers, and all that kind of thing. I mean, it was almost always a white culture. The black people were never excelled as much, especially the models, etc. So I can see there's a lot more black models now. There's a lot more different types of black models. You know, it's not just the ones that are just used for the extremely big lips or whatever. Like I say, black people have been used as art before. So I feel like I being an advocate, I wanna be an inspiration. I wanna be, you know, something for someone else to look at and be like, yeah, if he can do it, then I can do it. And even not in modeling, even in any other field, they can, I feel that they can do it just because, you know, there's other role models in there.
I think it can, but I do think it is changing a little bit. Like for example, what we're doing now, like things like this, seeing a lot more positive young black people on television in recent years, I think has really shown young people that they can do what they want to do, and I think a lot of them are really motivated at the moment, and I love that.
Yeah, I think it does. I think it does because everyone's got a stereotype, and in some situations it helps you, and in some situations it doesn't. And I think in terms of the creative arts, in terms of filmmaking, directing, stuff like that, I think music, you're alright. I feel like music, you've got a good deal there. But for everything else, I feel like it is quite difficult to get a foothold in that industry, especially because it's all about the people you know. And if you don't know those people, then you can't get in, because that's what I'm finding right now. That if you don't know people, it's a longer process.
I think, yeah, there are certainly stereotypes that can prohibit one's, you know, a young black person's development in this industry. You can often get pigeonholed or shoeboxed as one type of thing and only be that type of thing. But I think we're living in an age now where there's a higher level of awareness. There are more and more young black actors, and they're getting younger, who are breaking the molds and the stereotypes of what it has previously meant to be a black actor in the industry, what type of roles we tend to see ourselves in. I think it's, you know, there's still a long way to go, but I think we certainly come a long way and we're still going.
How can we change the spectrum for young black people inside and outside of the industry and make it that we have more equal opportunities?
But simply by awareness, knowledge, passing on knowledge. So I've been a signed artist now for a year, and I have learned so much in the last year that I can pass on to aspiring artists. It's unbelievable. Being an unsigned artist and being a signed artist are two different things as well, but the industry works in a very strange way. It's unlike any other industry, the music industry. I feel as though if people understand how to conduct themselves in certain situations and when they're having initial meetings with management, brands and everything else, I feel as though if they are prepped and ready for that, they'll achieve what they want to achieve a lot quicker.
I think what we can do is just speak to one another, really. Speak to one another, how can we help you? What do you need? I think there's this disconnection in the black community that people, which is not necessarily true, but what you see occasionally is that people don't want to help each other out, because if you say you want to do something, they see it as a competition. So rather than all of us coming together to do something, we're going against each other. So it's a competition. So rather than doing that, let's just all come together and put money within ourselves, within our community, within that young person that wants to do a particular thing.
It's a tough one. I think we just need to keep pushing. We need to keep pushing as a race, as a whole, as black people. I mean, nowadays, in the last 3-4 years, I've seen a lot more people pushing like black excellence and black beauty and really recognizing their power as black people. And social media's helped and played a big part in that. And I think it's really started to sow seeds into my generation now, the next generation, that, you know, recognize your power. Don't feel this suppression and feel like you've got to live up to the stereotypes and what people want you to be. So I feel like that needs to be pushed more in different ways, in TV and all sorts, so that the next generations to come that ain't even born yet, they don't even feel the separation between the races. So
how do we do that? How do we do that? Okay. Well, first of all, I think we have to kind of aspire a bit higher as well. Like, of course I'm an actor, but I want to see a wider range of, like you, Tianna, directors, producers, who are behind the camera, and who are the gatekeepers. Because ultimately, if we're getting more diverse people in those rooms that are making those decisions as to what gets commissioned and what gets greenlit, those people that are making those decisions, it means therefore we're going to be, automatically the story is going to be changing. We're not seeing the same narrative being played out. So that's what we need to be raising our aspirations for that to happen. We need to be in supportive of one another. There's this crab in a barrel thing where there's this thing where, because there's very few spaces where we see black people, for example, on TV, and rather than being happy for that person, you know, there can be like a negative energy, like, why not me, you know? But I honestly believe there is a space for everyone. I think it's this kind of one in, one out thing, and the effect of that is people have actually believed that we are just one, you know, token. And I'm really interested in exploring that, actually, the kind of psychological effects of tokenism and how we can take that on. So when you see that one black person having that TV role or on the stage and you wish that it was you, how does that affect you? Do you then try and copy the way that that black person is because you think, well, that's what's acceptable in order for me to get to that point? And I think if people were just themselves, and told their own individual story. Like I say, I'm not from London, I'm from Birmingham. So my experience growing up in Birmingham might be similar to that of London, but it will still be slightly different to that. So that's my story. That isn't anyone else's story. So I'll just say, be your authentic self, raise your aspirations, support black commerce, support your local community. That's how we can build, that's how we can get into certain arenas, work together, collaborate, put the ego aside, you know. That's all I can think of right now.
I just think we have to keep fighting. Equality is something that should just be, but unfortunately it isn't. And I think we just have to keep putting our message out there, whether it's through writing, poetry, anything you want to do. Like, you literally just have to do it. Like, I'm so glad that we're doing this today, because this is an example of something that's going to make a difference. And it doesn't matter how small it is, it can and it will make a difference.
Well, I'd say it's less about race and more about class. Because right now, the people in the industry that we want to go into, they've been in the industry for years and years and years. They're the kids of the kids of the kids of the kids who have been in this industry from the start. And because we're just trying to get in now, it affects all my friends. It affects my black friends, my white friends, my mixed race friends. Everyone's having the same struggle if they come from where we are. So I think it's more about giving those opportunities to everyone, no matter colour, creed, race, class, whatever. I think it's about making sure the people from whatever area you're from get the same opportunities as the people who have been in there for ages.
Changing the spectrum for young black people in and out of the industry so that we can have equal opportunities is something that I think will take time, will take persistence. It's one of those things that, you know, it's not one generation or one person that can, you know, make such a change. It's a change. change that happens over time, but what we can do is we can contribute to that change. Do you know what I mean? We can all pull weight, we can all carry the load until we see something happen. But it's a difficult one because, you know, when you have systems of you know, generations of institutionalized racism that hold us back, we have to be very careful and astute in how we move in our careers and the things that we want to achieve and what we do with the things that we achieve, what we do with the heights that we reach, what sort of message we portray to those younger than us. All of these things are important in sort of widening the spectrum and you know, enlarging the pool of opportunity for those that are coming behind us. And yeah, I think it starts with education, because it's easy, you know, once you get to a certain height to just be cool, to be happy with it. But the important question for me is, once you get to what you wanted to get to, what are you doing with that? Like, what do you want to do with that position you have? Because let's be real, like, kids know Will Smith's name, but they don't know the name of the guy that just made the maddest big breakthrough in the tech industry. So, you know, in this industry, we can be in a very considerable position of influence, and I think we just all need to be mindful of that. And once we truly are, that's, I think, when we'll start seeing change.
Who are your inspirations from the industry that are of colour?
Inspirations from the industry that are of colour? I've got to say, he's a lot younger than me, but I've met him a couple of times. Stormzy is a massive inspiration. He's a very hard-working young man. The Skeptors and the Wileys, the people that I grew up watching and listening to in this country, in terms of obviously the Michael Jacksons, and going back throughout history, there's been many, many black artists that have inspired me. I can't even name them off the top of my head now, there's so many, but right now the people that have inspired me are Darkus at Island, the president of the label. He's a massively important person. Austin Darbo, who is at Spotify, and he's a music curator there. Mr. Jam at BBC One Extra, who's one of the most amazing DJs that this country has at the moment, and he's now the top DJ at Radio One. Trevor Nelson, someone who I've grown up listening to his Radio shows and his compilation albums. Yeah, there's loads of people that are trailblazers in the industry that I've looked up to over the years.
My inspiration right now is a woman that I actually work with. She's called Darren from Taste Haven. She's a caterer. And I think the reason why is because she's so young, that compared to other caterers I've seen in the business so far, they're quite older, but she's quite young compared to them. And her food is absolutely banging. Oh my God. And she actually puts a lot of thought into her work, because she put a lot of presentations when it comes to, you know, catering, food service and whatnot. Whereas, like, usually with other, you know, Nigerian caterers, should I say, the food presentation is so crap, like, you know, you wouldn't even want to eat the food. The food is not that nice, the presentation is crap. But her food and her presentation is on point. So I say she's one of my inspirations in the industry so far. There's some other people as well though, like some other event planners and caterers and so on. Like young people that are out there, but I just don't know them personally. But they're all my inspiration, all the black people that is in the event planning industry.
Do you know what? I do quite a lot. Like, I'm quite a creative person, so I mean with music and modelling and acting, etc. So I look up to quite a few people, not a particular model to say, because modelling is always just sort of been my hobby thing. But I look up to people like Skepta, for example, for his drive. I watched Skepta's freestyle videos and F64s and stuff from when he was, he must have still been like 20, 26, 27 back then, but I was a kid. And so seeing him continuously doing what he's doing and kept keeping it real to himself until he has broken into you know, the limelight, and he's surpassed into celebrity status, I guess, a successful person now. And he still kept it real, and he's, you know, like the black tracksuit on the Fashion Week front row. That was an iconic moment, you know what I mean, for young black people in London. It was so genius. I mean, from producing to directing to rapping to designing, like he's all rounded, man. He's such a great inspiration, man. It's, yeah.
Who inspires me? Oh gosh, there's so many people. Well, I'll start at my doorstep and I'll say that no Madonna's my neighbour because she plays Hermione Granger and she's my onstage mom and she's just a phenomenal woman. On and off stage, like she's so talented. And then as a person, she's very warm and very giving. And yeah, I feel really honoured to play her daughter. So I actually watched her perform for the very first time at the Belgrade Theatre about 10 years ago, actually. And that was the first time I'd really seen black people on stage. And she was doing her Olivier award winning performance Raisin in the Sun by Lorraine Hansberry. It was phenomenal. And Martina Laird, Tanya Moody, Sophia Canedo, Angela Winter, Marion Jean-Baptiste, Sharon D. Clarke, just everyone that's in my phone basically, that happens to be a black woman and that has somehow managed to make a career in this industry long before I was even born, you know. These people inspire me. You know, if it wasn't for programs like Desmond's and you know, Paulette Randall, who was one of the producers on that, I wouldn't be here, you know. And then across the pond, of course, Queen Viola Davis. I think she's amazing. I think what's phenomenal about her is she speaks so openly and she speaks so honestly about her experience. And that is what's kind of raising the awareness and consciousness of other black women to also speak out about their experience. And she's gone on and made a production company. And when I see, you know, real black girl magic, basically. But, you know, my mom, those women that are hustling to put a meal on their table, you know, they inspire me too. You know, like I say, it's the day-to-day, really. It's the day-to-day moments to get by. It's hard enough being black, but being a woman on top of that, it's like an extra strike, you know? So, any of these people out here that are just kind of overcoming their, you know, they're more than their, they're not defined by their experience, you know? It makes them stronger. It's part of their story, but it isn't solely there. So all those people, plus many, many more, inspire me.
Everyone. I love Issa Rae because I love Insecure, Awkward Black Girl. I love her writing style and I just love the way she just being herself, and a lot of people have resonated with that. Who else? Kind of just love everyone. I like Maya Jama, the TV presenter, because again, she's just being herself and a lot of young girls are looking up to her and she's not always in makeup and heels and all that kind of stuff. She's just literally just woken up on video and just puts herself out there. That's what I like, just be yourself.
I know there's a lot of people who I just like the look of. Eric Andre, I love Eric Andre because he just doesn't care. He doesn't care about race, he doesn't care about anything. He's just there to have a good time and do his work properly. But in terms of people who are like me, I don't really have that many because most of the time we kind of get grouped in with other groups of people. So you don't really get mixed race stars. You don't get mixed race celebrities because they're often just called black or they're called white or they're called whatever. Like Obama, he's not black. Obama's not black. But, hey.
Okay, in the creative industries, those that inspire me of colour, myself, Labyrinth, the music producer, Dead or Alive?
Either way.
Okay, I'll keep it to those that are alive. I think Dr. Dre, figures like Dr. Dre and PDD, they're important. They're important figures for us to model 50 Cent to, just in terms of how they handle our business.
5 years, I want to be on a beach in Jamaica at the bottom of the drive from my house that I've built. No, I want to have made a couple top five albums. I want to have made a hell of a lot of money from music sales and performing. I want to have my own festival. And I want to have residencies in Dubai and Ibiza, throw my own parties and be a very wealthy person. And also employ a lot of aspiring artists that I see similar traits to myself in.
5 years, where do I want to be? I want to be traveling the world, really. I see myself, you know, learning a different language, living there for a while, and then going back home to Nigeria to live, and also having my own charity foundation back home in Nigeria, like a school or a hospital or something. So I'm 21 now, so I'm going to be 26 by that time. So hopefully I have like some sort of charity foundation back home.
5 years time, I want to be on a beach, FaceTiming my mum on the beach, somewhere else, telling her how great it is here, and really just pushing and striving. I mean, I'm a person who, you know, I do a short term plan for my near future, but I don't want to say like in 5 or 10 years time I want to just be doing that, and I'm just, you know, I'm working at that. Because I'll work at something and then within 2 months' time I'm working on something else, and I'm a man of, you know, variety, so I want to be excelling in everything and anything I try. So I couldn't tell you exactly in 5 years what it is I'll be doing, but I just know that whatever it is, I want to do it great and be successful at it.
Oh, in 5 years. I want to be healthy, I want to be happy. I'm all those things now, but I want that to continue. I'd like to build on my knowledge of my craft. I just want to be a better artist. I want to work with people that are going to help me on my journey and who I can help them on their journey in terms of you know, their craft as well. And building something great, whatever that may be, whether that's an event, whether that's a platform, whether that's a cause, a charity, some kind of long-lasting institution which is going to be made up of people that are passionate of a cause, something that's creative that I can pass on. I think that would be really great. But other than that, yeah, that's it.
I wouldn't be doing exactly what I'm doing now, just with a bigger audience, focusing more on my blog, I think. And I'm going to start an online store soon, so hopefully I'll just be successful doing both those two things, and I just want to be happy in my personal life.
5 years, well, right now I'm doing just odd bits and pieces for friends, for people who've just heard about me, kind of stuff like that. So I'd like for people to actively come to me, to go, Zackary Downs, that guy, he does good work, I want to go to him. I want my name to mean something in 5 years. So in 5 years, I want people to go, oh, this was made by Zackary Downs, and people go, oh, Zackary Downs, I like that guy. That's where I want to be in 5 years.
In 5 years, I want to be directing feature-length films for big production houses. I want to be starring in films for big production houses. I want to be scoring movies. Albums. I want to be working on a product design firm. I want to be well established with a creative.
Thank you.